Y'all know what's on, right?
Hey y'all.
Hey guys.
It's your girl Lex.
And it's B.
I forgot what I said.
Welcome to the Girls Room Podcast from the West Side with Love. Where welcome to the Girls Room Podcast.
Hi.
From the West Side with Love, where we not only talk about everything in the streets, but we leave you with a little bit of love.
Sound good to me. I'm just saying. I'm about to open the thing. Y'all, I got my blanket today. Cause she always got a blanket. I want a blanket too.
Y'all, behind this camera is a basket of blankets. She could have been had a blanket.
I know.
She just ain't grabbed it.
You're right. Oh, Lord, my feet tangled up in the microphone. Okay.
Not well. You entangled.
It's an entanglement.
What is wrong with us today?
Because that one, y'all gonna watch it and be like, that wasn't even that funny.
Right. It was funny to us.
Just laugh. It don't even matter.
It was funny to us.
So, what we drinking on?
All right, y'all. I believe this is the last of the series. Only this specific Trader Joe's series on Bring 'Em Out. Next podcast, next episode, we're probably going to have maybe a liquor. I don't know. Maybe a wine. But this is the last of the Trader Joe's series. So we're bringing out.
Bring 'em out. Peach. Bring 'em out.
Oh, shoot. The peach Bellini.
I hope this one is good.
I like peach Bellinis. I used to get them. I think I was first introduced to a peach Bellini when I went to Maggiano's one time. So, and they were pretty good. So I feel like this is gonna be good.
So, hopefully this is good. But anywho, what's up with you, girl? Or maybe let's pour our drinks first. I'm kind of sleepy now, too.
I'm very sleepy. But, okay, I have not been getting no good sleep since Sunday. And I think it's because of daylight savings.
Well, maybe I need to pour a little bit more.
Yeah. I think it's because of daylight savings. Like, literally.
That makes sense, though.
I don't know, because we get more sleep now. We got an extra hour, so I feel like I'm still on the less hours sleep schedule, so I got it at first. I was waking up an hour before I usually wake up. But technically, it was still the same time because we got an extra hour, whatever, whatever.
Right.
But after that, it was to the point where I go to sleep at like 10, 11. No, not even 10. I don't really go to sleep at 10. Like 11 or 12, and I wake back up at 3 and just be up till 6.
I don't like that.
Like, what is going on? Mm. And then the other day, I woke up at 6 and was just up. And I usually wake up at 7:30.
I be sleeping good.
Girl, I don't know what's wrong with
you. I been sleeping good. And then I be getting up at 5:30 in the morning to go to the gym. Like, now when I get up at 5:30 in the morning, of course, it feels late. Like, my body is not, it's not as, okay, as I've tired. Gotten used to it now, but I'm just not as tired.
Right.
So, it's better.
Right. You know? But now it's kicking my ass.
That's crazy.
Like, I'm going to sleep real good tonight because I don't know.
That's crazy.
Yeah, but that's how I've been feeling. I've been feeling tired. Not blessed, but tired.
Yeah.
Have you been feeling just tired?
I ain't going to care. This week and, like, this week right now has not been the best week for me.
Yeah, I've been. We talked about that.
Very. Mm-hmm. Sad, grief. So it comes in waves, and life just been lifing, you know.
Yeah.
So I just been in a, I don't know. I just been in a kind of funk. Like, I got the blues this week, y'all. Mm-hmm. Kind of bad.
It's okay. We all have our off days, off weeks, off months, off years.
I'm be alright. Yeah. I just, if you know me, you got my number. Check on me.
And pray for her, please.
Check on me and pray for me. Please.
And I'm going to let y'all know this. Grief does not have a time frame. We're going to say that. Okay?
You'll never stop grieving someone. Yeah. Like, I'm sure when I'm old, I'm still going to be sad and crying.
Right.
Yeah.
So send a quick prayer.
Yeah, please.
But God got you, sis. We got you. We're going to keep you uplifted. Thank you know, you can always call me.
Thank you. Oh, man. Let's taste this drink. Did you taste it?
No. I don't know why I'm nervous. I feel like it's going to be good. But I feel like we had just such a bad last drink, even though I kept drinking
it. Cheers. What are we cheersing to?
A good podcast.
We did that last time. We cheersing to a great rest of our year.
Yeah. Because, y'all, we got 2 months left. These last 2 months of the year, we got to make them count.
Okay, peach Bellini. Yeah, because the mangocini went to my name.
I be drinking these drinks. Like, I ain't drunk nothing all day.
Thursday.
That was good. For sure. We're going to finish that one.
I like that one. Yeah.
The peach Bellini is Bellini.
Like the mango was going to be like that.
Right. I feel like, I don't know, it was like, it has the same dynamic of
the mango,
but it's so much more subtle and yes, cute.
Yes, and I feel like the peach is just, it's just something about
it. It's like, peach. Subtle pop.
Yes.
Real elegant. The mango that mango was like, whoa.
The mango was like, Jesus.
Doing too much. Relax. Doing too much. Are you a beer? Are you a soap? What are you?
Wait.
Too much. Yeah, I mean, like that.
I think it's y'all favorite time.
Oh, wait. No, it's not.
It's not their favorite
what
time.
What we listening to?
Oh, you right. Rotation.
Because I sure was. Y'all we be ready to get to this box,
we
y'all.
Do, we love y'all. Y'all know what I've been listening to.
What you been listening to, girl?
Mariah the freaking scientist. Mariah from a freaking woman.
Y'all, if y'all don't listen to her, I advise y'all do. She was in her bag with this album. Like,
alive, child.
She was in her bag. And I watched the podcast with her recently. I've been watching a lot of them recently. But the specific one, she was basically saying how, I don't know if y'all listen to her, but I listened to her, so I understood it.
That's my girl.
All of her other albums and EPs were more, not super depressing, but it was like sad love. Yeah. And now you can tell this and one is just more like
love,
yes. Happy love. Like, yeah, I went through my moments, but this is love type shit. And I love it.
I love Mariah the Scientist. Like, I literally listen to her other two albums all the time.
Yeah.
But this one,
it's popping.
This one, this she one did snapped. Her big one. I ain't she even did. Care. She did her.
And
big
she writes
one.
All her songs, y'all.
I love that about her.
Sis snapped.
Okay. I love that about her because I love people that write their music because you can literally hear their life.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like people show you themselves through their music. Right. And I love that. And Summer Walker is like that, yeah, too.
And I feel like all of her Mariah songs, Summer songs, they might not have been. I feel like Summers might be more on the timeline, but Mariah, even if she's not going through that at that moment, she's still resembling something she's been through.
I love it. I like Mariah, it. Y'all. Favorite songs on there. Love Sick is my number one. From a Woman, 77 Degrees. And I will say the last one is Heaven is a Place on Earth.
I really like Heaven's Place on Earth. I want to say my top is 77 Degrees. That might be my second. Honestly, From a Woman and Ride are going neck to neck for me. I really like Ride. Like, I like Ride because that's literally like Ride or Die type shit. That one and From a Woman are going neck to neck for me right now. So From a Woman is just a lovey-dovey.
I love it.
She's basically saying that it was a man that was being a man, but you cannot deny your feelings for a woman or from a woman. It's really opening the man up. Like, nigga, you really lovey-dovey.
Yes.
And I got to you. I made you lovey-dovey, yes. And I love it. It's
love
so
it.
Cute. It's so warm.
And she loves it, bro.
Yeah. You can't deny
can
it.
In her music, she really loves Yantha.
She does.
Okay. All right. Now on to our favorite part for real.
The box. We're not even gonna name this, in my opinion, no more. It's just gonna be literally the box. Needs to
just be called the box. At this
I'm gonna start putting the song "The Box" is the sound effects for this segment. Why do it look so perfect? Oh, it's time to get a little ghetto.
A BBLs.
Them BBLs.
Out of Miami's.
Now, if you don't know what a BBL is,
that's you know when people be they be they confused don't be between what a BBL is and all the other stuff.
All the other stuff. So Brazilian butt lift is a Brazilian butt lift. It's when girls get fat, sucked out their stomach and like some other areas maybe, but mostly stomach, and put in their behind.
Tush.
Child, I feel like,
would you get a BBL?
No, bitch, I would just get liposuction. I don't need
right. I feel like I don't need no more hips and no more ass.
I don't need
than I
nothing
got
else back here.
Nothing else down there.
But it can go from over here.
Okay. Yeah. But honestly, I won't get lipo. I feel like if anything, I would work out and probably do like a body contour.
You know, when you go, I feel like I've heard this to where, because I know people that have BBLs. So I know that when you go to the doctor, they will give you, like, you would have to do, you have to get down to a certain weight or something. Like, depending on, it just depends. But you might have to work out and, like, lose a few pounds first and then do it. Once I lose the 10 pounds, I don't want the BBL no more.
What's the point?
Because I'm finna keep on going to the gym.
And so, and I hate when females do this. In order to keep your BBL sustainable, you have to work out.
And eat right.
Y'all just spend all this money to get a BBL and be looking like a pancake.
I know a girl who got a BBL.
In 6 months.
I know a girl who got a BBL same day off the table. She want to go get Burger King.
I know you lying.
I swear.
And the thing about BBLs as well, I done watched like videos, like probably like YouTubers I done followed before. And not saying YouTubers always get BBLs, right, but that's just an example.
Regular people get BBLs.
Yeah. But females that get BBLs that I've actually watched their journey because they documented it, mm-hmm. It's very painful. The recovery is very painful. And it looks terrible. It looks like you have the gauze, bloody the body gauze
hell
that they put on them. It's bloody.
Hell.
Y'all have to sit in one of those chairs with the booty out, cut yeah out. Y'all need help.
I went to Miami and I saw two girls getting rolled in the airport. Like, they was coming back to Atlanta from Miami. They was getting rolled in the airport in a little wheelchair. And while we were sitting there waiting on the plane, they're on their knees. Like, they were facing the chairs and they was on their knees because I guess they was tired of sitting in the chair, but they can't sit no other way than either on their knees or in a chair. Just imagine being on a plane and getting down on your knees on the plane. Like, in your, like, you, no. I'm not
doing that. You doing all this?
I'm not doing that.
For extra ass.
You're doing all this so somebody's son could be looking at you and these niggas raggedy anyway.
And I always wonder, what is the end goal in it?
I feel like most girls that get BBLs do that shit because they want to look good to a man.
But you know how people be like, I do it for myself.
It's cap.
But I feel like if you do it for yourself, then you should work out. It's not about what it looks like. It's
amazing
what it feels like. Like,
amazing.
You should, if you're so stuck on looking good for yourself, then you would not only want to look good for yourself, like Coke bottle shape, whatever, but you would also want to be healthy.
Healthy.
So I just be
healthy
confused
is the thing for me. I'm like, me personally, I thank you, God. God bless me with a nice body. So, or a nice shape. So I'm not really too concerned about that. I just be concerned about the healthiness.
And I be thinking about that too. Like, what I think the same way. If I didn't have a nice shape.
Because
I feel like I have a nice shape. I have curves in the right places.
I feel like if I ain't had no butt, I might want a BBL too.
But honestly, I feel like I just go harder in the gym. Maybe because I'm one of those type of people where I'm so concerned about my health. And I pride myself in having good health. Yeah. I still wouldn't do it.
I don't know. I just feel like
I wouldn't do anything that's... I'm a natural person.
And I don't knock anybody that has a BBL. Like, I feel like BBLs are nice sometimes. Like, people get their BBLs done and they look nice. Like, but I just feel like, first of all, if you're going to do it right. Don't be going to nobody. If you're going to do it, stop coming out these BBLs with these little ass legs. And that big old mosquito bite butt, like an ant. You like an ant, or you like you. It's just not. It don't look good. Like if you are skinny, and you getting a BBL, make sure you tell them thighs too, baby. Thighs and butts. Y'all be just getting
BBL. I think
skinny BBL.
Yeah, whatever that is. I don't know.
It's a YouTuber I follow. She got a skinny BBL, and. It don't even look like she got nothing done.
And that, sometimes it be looking too much. Sometimes it's like you ain't got nothing done. And sometimes
but she
you got
lucky.
It done and then don't maintain it. So I just be confused
now,
as hell.
Once they don't maintain it, I be like, bro, are you serious? You went and go, you gonna sit up there and get you some surgery. Just to get fat again, and then what you gonna do? Go get some more surgery.
What they do.
They do
after
that.
A while, they will turn around.
Baby, they go 3 rounds for BBL.
Exactly. Why?
Because they too lazy to work out.
That's dumb.
So every time they gain weight, they just gonna go get another BBL. One thing I hate about BBLs, this is the one thing that I hate so much about BBLs. When people get BBLs, right? They don't gain weight in the same way. So, like, if I was to get a BBL or if I was to get lipo or whatever, I have a fupa. So, if I get that, it's not going to form into a fupa anymore. I'm just going to be wide as hell. So, when I'm gaining weight, my waist is going like this. Instead of me getting fat on my stomach, I'm just spreading out.
I never do that.
It looks terrible. It's not even me being educated. It's just me having seen so many BBLs. And I'm like, bro, so when y'all gain weight, y'all just
you
look
like,
seriously.
So now you
so when you gain
way.
Weight,
you was this way.
You, it ain't dropping down. Like, it's not dropping down like fat. It's just getting wide and you look like you play football.
Like, what about the ones who, like, literally don't have no ass at all?
Girl, you better go do some squats.
That shit.
You better eat your rice and cabbage.
You know how hard it is to get a
and you
ass
better
in
be
the
committed.
Gym.
The way you committed to making that money, the extra money to get flown out and do that. And then the men be so, like, willing to, like, yeah, I pay for my girl to get a BBL. Y'all lazy, too.
The niggas, they like, yeah, she
instead
want
of fucking
none.
Saying... Yeah. Here go the money to get a BBL.
Man, here, get you a gym membership. Here go $50.
We about to get this gym membership together.
Nah, for sure.
I'm going to help you work out. I wish you wanted to learn how to do some RDL or something.
Nah, for sure.
And, you know, do what makes you happier. Do what makes you feel good. But sometimes I just feel like that's kind of the lazy route to do it.
To each his own, because I wouldn't get no BBL, but I already got a big butt, so I don't need one. But
you know what's funny?
What?
Somebody had asked one of my friends, did I get my body done?
Somebody's asked me that before. I remember when I had got like real skinny. I was just not the size I am now. I was like so super smaller than this. And I remember like several people was like, you look like you got your body done. And I'm like, no, I'm just fine.
Right.
The hell?
And mine was the fact that, okay, yeah, we was in college and we were all kind of smaller or whatever, but I honestly feel like a woman doesn't grow their full body out until at least
25.
Right. Mm-hmm. And I feel like at 25, even at 26 is when my body started to change as far as like reacting to certain, like my body had an intolerance to certain foods and all of that stuff, yada yada yada. You know, I got a little sciatica, hurt a little different. But as far as like the shape of my body, I thought in my early 20s I was done growing. So I was still slim. I was a slim thick. Now I'm more of a thick thick. Mm-hmm. But that's just because my body wasn't done growing. Yeah, my hips spread a little bit more. Yeah. Everybody said childbearing hips. I don't have no children, but my hips done spread it. My boobs done got a little bigger. And next thing you know, people asking, did I get my body done? And I'm just like, no, I just wasn't done growing.
I hate that that is the, like, conversation. Like,
because it's so common, especially in Atlanta. We from Atlanta.
But I feel like y'all don't know the difference between a BBL body and a natural body. Because most of the time, it's an obvious difference. You can tell.
Because why can't my race, the hip ratio be what it is naturally?
Anywho. Ooh, I like this one. Advice to your 21-year-old self.
Oh, wow.
Ooh, I was actually thinking about this part the other day. That's interesting. I wonder when we're going to get that one.
Let me look. Talked it up.
Advice to my 21-year-old self.
I got to look back on 21.
Right, like, what was I doing at 21? When I was 21, I lived on my own. I think one thing I would tell my 21-year-old self would be to relax. Like, you'll be so worked up, worried about the stuff that don't even... If you could literally look forward, like, look to the me now and see what I'm dealing with.
Yeah.
Girl, calm down. Freaking relax. I would tell myself to leave that nigga alone.
If I could put it in one phrase, I would tell my 21-year-old self, you don't know what's coming. Like, girl, you don't know what's coming. And that could be, it's more of in a blessing way than anything. But of course, it's like the things that I was worried about at 21 really didn't matter. Well, everything matters, it's so much more that you're going to have to endure in life. Like, you're probably going crazy over this one minute thing. And it's much more that you're going to endure that is going to make you so much stronger. But also, you don't know what's coming into where... It's not sure blocking your blessings, but you're feeling like this is all life has for me, but it's so much more and so much better.
I would tell myself to pray more. Mm. And saying pray more, like, I pray a lot. I've always been a very big, you know, like, I've always had a good relationship with God, and I pray a lot. But, you know, I feel like when you're young, you pray more when something's happening. And you don't pray as much on the days that things aren't happening. So I would encourage, like, I would be like, you need to pray when things are good.
I think, but when you just said that, I think it's more so we pray, when you say we pray when things are happening, I feel like when things are happening, if it's not happening for the good, we're praying that it gets better.
Yeah.
But when things are really good, we're also praying and thanking God that it's very good. Yes. But it's the median part that we're not so focused on sometimes. Yeah. And I would focus more on that too.
Praying when stuff is just
okay.
Yeah.
Or you're
like continuing to you're thank content. God when things are just,
content. Yeah. And I realize that now, like, being 29, my prayer changed. I kind of have not a set prayer that I say every day along with the certain things that I'm going with at that time, but I kind of do. And I've noticed in my prayer now, I always thank God, even if I'm going through it, even if I have it all that I feel like I need at that moment, I thank God for the simple things. I always thank Him for having a roof over my head. I thank Him for clothes on my back. Mm-hmm. I thank Him for the food that provides a nourishment to my body and also having good health. Mm-hmm. I always pray for that.
I will say this year, I don't know, something last year just kind of clicked for me. And I was just like, bro, like, God give me what I need and He give me what I want.
Yeah.
And I be so worked up. I feel like I get so anxious, like hoping and hoping and hoping that I get what I want. And then it be like, you already had it. You just had to calm down, you know? But this year, I feel like once I moved out, that was like the biggest thing for me to like, I was like, dang, God really be taking care of me. So from that, like I feel like I have prayed almost every day since I've been living on my own. Mm-hmm. Even when nothing was going on and I was perfectly fine, I'm just praying every day because, like, I've been so grateful. Like, just, you know, so I think something I would tell my 21-year-old self is just, like, gratitude. Yeah. Gratitude is very important.
Wow. You said something there because I feel like the last year and a half of my life, I've learned gratitude.
It's so important. You have to remember to be grateful for the small things that you have because, I hate to say that things could be worse, but things could literally be worse.
Yeah.
And just be grateful for the stuff that you have.
Mm-hmm. I always say gratitude is attitude. Like, that's kind of been my motto for the last year and a half. Like, gratitude is attitude. And I don't even know where I got that from or if I just thought about it on my own, but I think it was me and a couple of people was talking about just attitudes as it is. And like I said, some people might see my bad attitude some days and think I just generally have a bad attitude. Yeah. Or they might just think, oh, you know, if somebody always see me happy, they're like, oh, you have a great attitude. But at the end of the day, regardless if I'm having a bad day or if I'm having a good day, my attitude is always gratitude. Yeah. Gratitude is the attitude.
Or you have to be grateful for the stuff that you have because remember at one point in time, this is something that you probably prayed for.
Right.
So don't get into what you pray for and then forget to be thankful for it.
Right, because literally, 21-year-old, you was wishing you was at that point, at literally. That moment. Yeah, same.
I would tell my 21-year-old self to really know your worth and don't let nobody play with you because you really that bitch. So why would you even do that? Like,
hello.
Why you want to be played with for?
The fuck?
Literally, because like what, because I'm like real in my baby, it's strict over here, okay? It's real strict. Like a nigga blink his eye too quick and you got goodbye. Good,
that's an ick. Goes back to the icks.
I'm talking about one sassy statement and it's goodbye. Really open your eyes and pay attention to the people that you got around you. Because, yeah. Don't be around. Like, I feel like back then I was around people because of, like, I used to think that being friends with somebody for a long time meant that you guys were friends. Like, how me and you been friends since we was 8. But everybody don't have, I haven't had a friendship with everybody else. Like the friendship that I've had with you, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. So like, even though I may have known this person for a long time, it doesn't mean we're supposed to be friends.
Right. It might be a season. Exactly. Yeah, I feel that.
A reason, a season, and a lifetime.
Ooh, I ain't never heard that one before.
People come around for a reason, a season, or a lifetime.
Wow, I've never heard.
I heard that.
I always say it's a reason for the season, or it's a season for the. Let me shut up. I don't know the reason and the seasons. I heard that one, but the lifetime, that added some wisdom on it, honey.
You're gonna either have somebody in your life for a reason, you're gonna have somebody in your life for a season, or that person is meant to be with you forever.
I love that.
Yeah,
I just want to let y'all know I'm meant to be with her forever. So
literally, we meant to be with each other forever. So.
It's cool.
So trending freaking topic, man.
Are we talking about Keith Lee?
Yes.
Y'all, he done came to Atlanta and shook the table.
I'm talking about this.
And y'all showed y'all ass on top of the table. Damn, Atlanta.
I am disappointed. You know, I'm very disappointed in y'all, but I'm not surprised.
Disappointed but not surprised because I remember the first video that he made when he got to Atlanta. This man was confused as hell. He was just like, yeah, I went to this, restaurant. I tried to order, and they said they don't take orders. And I was just like, welcome to Atlanta.
They don't take orders. Oh, my God.
You got to come in and sit down to eat. I said, welcome to fucking Atlanta.
Y'all be killing me with these raggedy-ass
rules and regulations.
And that's why I don't eat half at half of them damn places that he went to.
Yeah, why be at home cooking?
I'll be at home cooking, or I go to Flying Biscuit.
What the fuck? That was. That was so specific, nigga. Damn.
The real Milk and Honey, you can't do shit.
You know what's now, funny?
I want y'all to know the real Milk and Honey and Milk and Honey on Cascade. Oh, what is it? Cascade?
I don't think I ever
it's
been to
two
the real.
Different places.
I've never been to the real Milk and Honey on Cascade.
I love Milk and Honey on Cascade. You know one thing about Milk and Honey? If your whole party is there, I mean, if your whole party ain't there, they'll still sit you down.
But yeah, that's Atlanta, I'm not even gonna care. Y'all should be ashamed of y'all still.
Y'all should. And I get it, like, Atlanta is like a hot commodity popping city right now, but that don't mean y'all gotta be fucking rude and have all these goddamn
y'all raggedy
shit going on. Like,
hell.
Are y'all crazy?
No, I feel like that shit is like that because these people in Atlanta don't give a fuck about no customer service. All they care about
everybody in Atlanta is celebrities. You a waitress, you a celebrity.
Baby, you can't even get hired in a restaurant without having 1,500 followers.
So back in like 2018, 2019, I was just trying to be a little waitress at one of the, I'm not going to name the establishment they is popping or whatever, and I ain't got time for nobody coming after me.
Right.
But they had the nerve. I had all the credentials. I came up there looking cute and fly. I just felt like I was going to get the job. And they asked me this one question, and I just walked out. They said, do you know anybody famous? I said, I gotta have connections to somebody famous in order to be able to get somebody some drinks. Bye. I walked out.
So that means if you know somebody famous and you look cute and you go in one of these restaurants, they just gonna hire you. You ain't never had no serving experience. You're a terrible server. You are not bringing them no business by knowing somebody famous. You're actually losing them business by not being a good server.
I've been following Keith Lee for a minute based off of his... It's not even about his reviews. It's his... Not politeness. I don't know how to say it.
He's
but
so generous.
His generosity in him being so genuine as a person. He's not sitting here to tear down. And he's a food critic. But his main goal is not to criticize. He critiques. He does not criticize. He's going to let you know what it is for sure. Some of them might not be so good, but I feel like one of his main purposes is to highlight more restaurants so they can get better business.
Exactly.
And if you felt that's on you. That's not on Keith Lee. It's not on him. That's really on you. You just mad because you got exposed for your bad business.
Our street topic today is funny. It's pretty interesting, y'all. Would you name your child Junior? Would y'all name y'all? I don't want to ask y'all that.
It'd be so many names that be blowing me. But honestly, I would not name my child Junior.
I would not name my child Junior.
I don't care how long. I don't care how long we done been married, how much I love you. Why we just can't get another name? I'm just confused as hell.
Let me tell you something. If I'm married and my husband want me to name our child Junior, we're going to be in an argument about it. Because I'm going to be like, no. And when they hand me them papers in the hospital,
I'm going to mark baby, that. I'm going to put a strike through it and put another
name. I'm not going to hand it to you because I already know you finna write Junior on you. So go on, hand me them papers so I can write his real name on here because he will not be no freaking Junior.
I be thinking like, is it really a legacy or did y'all get lazy? Legacy or lazy?
I feel like...
I feel like you about to say some bullshit.
All right. This is my take on it. When people name their kids Junior, right? I'll be feeling like some people name their kids Junior because at that time, they just love their daddy so much.
But it's another way you can honor them by then giving that baby that name.
They be loving them kids' daddy so much, y'all. Or, like, I feel like partially the reason for some people be naming their kids Junior because they feel like, oh, if our son named Junior, you know what I'm saying, he'll be more active if he got a Junior.
It's giving you trying to make up for the shit you didn't do.
It's giving.
I don't like that.
It's giving don't do that shit. It's giving. Why the fuck do you play so much?
Because I don't want to hear El Jaber Eugene.
Don't name them kids Junior. And then I feel like when you name your son, or because most of the time it's sons. Tiana Taylor's daughter was a Junior. But you know what's so weird?
That was kind of cute, though.
It was cute, but it's funny because her name is not nobody's exact name.
Exactly.
They just put Junior. I feel like when you name your kid Junior, you are literally just like...
It's giving something missing out your life.
You're literally just setting him up for failure.
I don't think he
and not, that shit and funny not, and not saying that daddy is a failure, right? Not saying that daddy is a failure. But what if they daddy is?
But that's what I'm saying. Like, I feel like they trying to live vicariously through their child because they didn't get to do the shit that they were supposed to do. So they just like, well, I'm gonna name you Junior because I was a failure. So I'm about to make up through you because you're gonna be better than me.
I was at the airport. And I hear this man, and he had his son with him, and the people, I guess they asking, like, I don't know, they was asking, we had security, so they asking for passports and all this, or not passports, well, they was asking them for passports, but he said, oh, he has the same name as me. I was like,
but y'all still two different people. When he people.
Said, I was like, poor baby.
Oh, he probably say that everywhere they go to.
Freaking baby.
But y'all still not the same person. He still need his passport.
I feel
the fuck. Y'all think y'all making a minion? I'm confused as hell.
When people name that kid Junior, I feel like that's what it is.
It just be giving you a failure.
Minions. Like, this is y'all little minion right here. Like, please. But I feel like when people name their kids Junior, you are literally stripping your child their own identity.
I get that.
Like, let them have their own identity. They don't want to be named after you. They might don't even
already,
like that name.
They already didn't ask to be here.
Literally.
Now you make me you again? God damn.
I'm you reincarnated? Jesus.
And no offense to y'all, this shit just funny as fuck right now.
No offense to anybody who named that child Junior.
I have friends that are juniors. I'm sorry, y'all, but this shit is funny as hell.
Don't name your child Junior.
You know what be pissing me off more than Junior?
The third.
Not even heavy.
What?
Because I saw this shit the other day. When the parents mix their names.
Did you see
the other day with the niggas?
The mama named Michael the mama named Anna and the daddy named Michael Mahanna.
It was some dudes that escaped from the prison in Macon, right? And they found two of them in Atlanta. One was at the Huntley around the corner from him. I think I was in the elevator with him. He was real nice. But when I saw they caught him and I saw what he looked like, I said, that nigga looked like the man I was in the elevator with the other day. Oh. But they said it's like two or three of them. It was two of them still left on the run, right? And one of their names was Jennifer.
So the people in the comments on Instagram,
what the fuck? They wasn't concerned about them escaping. Somebody in the comments said, what the fuck is Jennifer? I'm thinking his daddy name was John and his mama name was Jennifer.
That's what it's giving. But why the fuck do they be doing
Nobody
that?
Nobody gave a fuck that these niggas was on the run. They was trying to wonder why his name was Jennifer.
I hate when they get all the way to number four. Like, oh my.
It's so, like, oh.
Y'all thought this name was that good that you used it four times?
But once it's a fourth, I'm like, y'all gotta have a strong bloodline. Like, y'all have some type of legacy that y'all cannot let go of.
I know one person that's a fourth.
Yeah, we know the same person. Yep,
the same person. Yep. That's the only fourth I know.
I know when that's a third. We know when that's a third.
Yeah, I know. I feel like I know a few thirds.
The one that we know that a third, that's a third, that, you know, bloodline. They have a very strong bloodline. Mm-hmm. I understand why he's a third.
But he's not going to name his child.
I don't think he would. But I get it, because he definitely has a very strong bloodline. And it's a very honorable.
I feel like the fourth bloodline.
Yeah, for sure. Both of them, yeah. But other than that,
if
your dad worked at Family Dollar all day,
your baby daddy, Ray down the street, don't name that baby Ray Ray Jr., please. And then my thing about it is, some of y'all or some people name their kids Junior, and then they daddy be a Debbie. And it just be like, you named him after this man, and then he being a Debbie, and
y'all trying to please I don't know what the dynamic of the relationship
I think some people name their kids Junior because they be trying to please the man.
Yeah.
Please don't do that shit.
Nah, for sure. Please. Don't.
Well then.
All right. Wrapping it up.
Okay, mine is simple and cute. It says, better is on the way. Take care of yourself now so you can embrace and sustain it when it arrives.
Oh.
Because, honey, we be stuck in a rut. Nigga.
Yeah, thinking about.
We don't know what's about to be next, but it's better. You just got to get ready for it.
Okay, mine says, even if you're not where you want to be, know that you are exactly where you're meant to be to get there.
Mm. Because God always be aligning them steps, honey.
Amen. He know what he doing. He know what he doing. Trust him, man.
Never doubt it.
All right, man. We out. See y'all next time.
We love y'all.
Peace up. A-Town down.